Hey.
Hiya. I'm Sawyer. 3 years ago, a group of friends decided to combine efforts and start a company. And every year, A-Major Films learn so much. This is what we do. We make movies.
So we were going to AmVets to get a wedding dress. Anything else?
If you need more clothes, we're getting
clothes and stuff, because we're doing a period piece.
Perhaps a bow tie.
So, I have some bow tie.
Oh, we should look for props, too, if we're out there. All right, so we've been on the road for a solid 30, 35 minutes, maybe 40.
Yeah.
It's pretty bad.
Okay, we have gone everywhere. We almost went to Canada to go to an AmVets.
All right, team, we made it. Now we have to go inside, find that wedding dress, and then
wedding
we can call
dress
it
necessarily.
Night.
Yes, we do.
Older style dress, really old style dress.
Okay.
Right? Oh,
dude.
Dude, this is definitely Gabby's size.
It has sleeves.
Does this one got the veil?
That's the question.
We faced a problem. The dress was a little tight, so we have Alright, so basically, we have to cover this up a little bit, but we have a tie here. We're supposed to keep the ends together. And yeah, he's being our nice little model.
I'm Yale Fried. I am the director at A-Major Films. Directing, more than anything, takes a vision, and then beyond a vision, it takes almost a narcissistic belief that what you have to say is the most important thing.
Aww. Where's Canon and D where you need it? All right, Nicole went over there.
I'm Nicole Lucca. My job is, for the most part, writing. I also am a producer and an actress. I've been used to writing short stories where you can just use thought and narration and prose, but with screenplays, it's more you have the dialogue on the page and you have the stage direction, so you kind of have to narrow it down into what you're thinking of into a small amount of words to interpret your vision across. Well, usually we have one connected idea before we actually start writing a script, so it's not like I write something and then I give it to him and he's like, I thought you were gonna write a movie about babies, and it's like a military film. Like,
in general, we always have some level of communication before writing begins, so that both the writer and the director are completely involved during the writing process, so I'm not getting anything unexpected.
Oh my god, I have...
It's
freaking
cheap. Dude,
I really like your hair like that.
Okay, if... Yeah, if she really likes it, I guess.
Here, Josh, you can
use
this.
I don't know yet. I'm
going to
keep it over here.
Sawyer and Gabby about acting stuff?
Josh, I'm going to need you to act in your footage.
So I'm going to do my best to direct you through it and help you through it, because, you know, it's, you know, whatever. But... Forgetting about that, I want you guys to really just feel comfortable.
Gerber, what are you doing to get into character right now?
I'm
put your volume.
Making up my own name, my own backstory.
You guys, turn on the music.
And envisioning how it would feel to marry someone
turn it down.
That you've loved for a while and want to spend the rest of your life with.
Sorry, what are you doing right now to get yourself into character?
Basically immersing myself in what is going on right now. Basically, you know, marrying the girl that I've been wanting to be with for a long time. So, I'm filling my head with thoughts of those awesome memories and making something out of this. I'm excited.
Peter, what are you doing right now?
Setting up a tripod.
What do those do?
They stand.
For what purpose?
To hold the camera.
As bright as it can go, mm-hmm.
Oh, is that like this?
Yes.
How do you decide how bright the lights will be and such?
In this particular shot, I need them to look really emotionally into it, but I need them to look creepy as well. So in this particular case, if you look at Sawyer right now, there are bags under his eyes just basically from the light shooting upward. So in this case, I need the lights as bright as can go because we're going to shut off all the natural light in the room. So combined with the fog that we're having a little bit and these lights, it's going to give an entire ambiance that we need to see. Okay, video rolling.
Alright,
get ready. Let's go.
Peter,
point a little bit lower.
I guess.
Okay.
So why are we smoking up this room?
He's 1940s, I'm gonna make me look like he's smoking in his office.
Yep.
Because smoking indoors is pretty chill.
Smoking
like
was a huge thing. I mean, I'm young, but everyone's.
And you'll notice the smoke is hanging much better in the air because it's colder in this room.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you do have the open windows.
Yes.
So yeah. You like your little setup typewriter, rotary phone. All right. Time for some more acting.
All right.
I know I'm wearing red suspenders, but it's gonna be black and white, so it should be fine. You know,
touch his face.
Just a little bit of
awesomeness.
Yeah. I don't remember. Press up the phone.
Uh huh. Yeah. Uh huh.
And then as soon as you see the camera, you're like, put that away. Like, go away. Put that away. And then he can be able to start smiling, and then he'll kind of be like, do a spin, and he can just be like, flash open the jacket, do like a quick spin or whatever. Almost knock over the lamp, but not quite. And then.
Oh, I was gonna be like, I'm totally gonna knock over the lamp.
You're incredible.
Alright, ready? And. Action.
Check the stuff, girl.
we're filming some more stuff.
Don't stress us out.
And when we do a period piece, it's so much fun because we can incorporate aspects of a century we belong to. So we can really do some fun artistic stuff with what we wear and what we do. Yeah, so this is why we make movies, because it's so much fun.
I've never played anybody from the 1940s before. Most of my characters, aside from maybe one, are from present day, so it's really cool to try to be somebody from a time that I'm not used to being in.
Okay.
There you go.
You're gonna be walking together and filming Gabby, then you're gonna tell her to go over there.
It's on YouTube, what?
Okay, model.
So you're Peter. So as a member of crew, what are some stuff you gotta do?
I carry stuff, I drive people places, I have to set up the entire set before the actresses and actors get there. I have to take down the set, work fog machine, work lights, help set up boom pull, sometimes do boom pull, I stay there for the editing process, and I help reshoot scenes.
That's very straightforward. Yeah, I think we're good.
Yeah, alright, that's it.
Crew.
All
right,
I do the exact same thing.
Throw one at her.
Nicole, your head is in the way.
3, 2, 1, hey!
Perfect.
Nicole, hey! Wonderful kind
Nicole,
of day.
Nicole, I'm kidding.
So we've been filming all day, and it's been really looking cool, you know, simulating an old 30s, 40s camera. But yeah, we've been doing a lot of first-person stuff, a lot of cute stuff, and I love cute movies. So it was really nice having some cool chemistry with Gabby and being able to make a really cute movie, so yeah. Let's go do stuff.
Peter, you cannot be there.
I'm just gonna
go. You cannot be there.
Peter, literally, no. Peter, literally, no.
Peter, they literally know.
Peter!
Peter, here, I can't get a spot for you.
No! I'm going near the door! No! The door! The door! Why? Look at you groggily, and then you're gonna kind of like go to this, and then, and then, no, just be like, put away the camera, put away, like, and then anyway, turn on the light, sit up in bed. Sorry, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Models.
Lights off.
I like the,
All right, sorry, look at the mirror for a second, keep your
arm. How bad is Sawyer's breath?
There we go.
There we go.
And that's a wrap.
That's a wrap.
That's a wrap. We did it.
Woo!
Yay. We're doing a voiceover part. We have the boom pull set up right here. Computer with the lines right here to read. Any remarks? Yeah.
3 a.m.
Essentially, we take the raw footage and edit it down to really get the product that we want in the end, or at least the product we saw in the beginning. Now everyone else can see it.
This is where it goes from an idea and a vision to actually making it happen. For us is right here, you're going to see a standard shot that came right out of our camera, and this is going to be brought now. This is a little bit speeded up in order to match old film, and we'll pick up a quick second right here, and I'm going to go through the process. I'm going to first darken the shot greatly and add a vignette frame, then add in a super 8mm effect, which is from an old camera. I'm adjusting all these effects. I've just pre-done these to make it a little easier for you to watch. Then that's putting a little bit more film grain on it. This is going to give it the aged film process. It's going to give everything you want to see, but we still have the color here, and this was made in the 1940s. That's the ideal. So you bring the color back down. And watching it all together, this is what you get to make it look like it was shot in the 1940s.
And that's it. That's how you make a movie. You know, we've been doing this for so long, it's almost second nature. And one day, we could do this for real. And have a budget, have resources, more than we already do.
But it's all been worth it. It's all been worth it.
Why don't we just do it in